morning. Good morning and welcome to First Church of Winsted. I did not want to stop you from playing. The music was just delightful. What was that? Chopin's First. Beautiful, beautiful, magnificent. Thank you very much. Let's begin worship. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Amen. Let's praise the Lord today. And now let us hear our gathering worship music, hymn number 27. We come to worship God who has made us and known us. We come to celebrate God's presence among us. We come to follow Jesus who leads us to new life. We come with joy knowing in Christ we have eternal life. We come to listen to the Holy Spirit who calls us forth. May we enter this worship knowing the Spirit is alive among us. Amen. O God, send your Spirit into this place. Touch and heal our brokenness and lift us out of despair and doubt. Dry the tears of pain and sorrow. Comfort and nourish us with the many blessings of your great love. O God, may we flourish and blossom into the warmth and compassion of your healing love and grace. Hear us now as we pray that which Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Glory be to
Now, we welcome each of you to participate in tithing and giving of our offerings. I had a curious experience this morning. I usually give my tithing in cash, but I said this morning, let me try this online giving. And I came in and I registered with PayPal, and then I did the little PayPal, whatever that is, QRC. Thank you, that little thing, the picture in the box. And I did everything. And when I went to register my tithe, it said there was an error. And so today, I can't give. So I'm going to figure it out. But later on this week, a tithe will come in from my phone to First Church. And this is your opportunity to do likewise, or to place your tithe into the mail so that this church might continue to do the work that it was called on to do. And we thank you for all of the tithes and gifts that you have been giving, continually giving to this ministry throughout this very difficult COVID season that we've been experiencing. We thank you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you now in the name of Jesus Christ for your goodness, grace, and mercy, and for the ability that you've given to this church to continue to do its ministry and to not miss a beat in terms of our financial obligations. We thank you, Lord, for the stewardship of your people, their dedication, and their faithfulness. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Scripture this morning is from Psalm 111. Had we had a reader scheduled, I was only going to ask them to read the first four verses, knowing that I really intended for us to study the whole 11 verses, the whole 10 verses, I'm sorry, of the psalm. So I'm going to read the whole Psalm 111. And I'm reading from the New International Version. Praise the Lord. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart, in the company of the upright, in the congregation. Great are the works of the Lord, studied by all who delight in them. Full of honor and majesty is his work, and his righteousness endures forever. He has gained renown by his wonderful deeds. The Lord is gracious and merciful. He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever. He has shown his people the power of his works, giving them the lands of other nations. The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever, enacted in faithfulness and uprightness. He provided redemption for his people. He ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal praise. Let's pray. Father, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart will be acceptable to you and to the listeners. I pray, Lord, that you'll use each and every thought and the desires of my heart, that you will get glory, honor, and praise. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. The objective of this sermon is to reinforce a new phrase into the vocabulary of every worshiper of First Church this morning. I continue to lament that COVID restrictions have done to our ability to gather for Sunday worship together in this wonderful sanctuary. It is sad that we can't hear Trisha play this marvelous organ over here. It's a shame that the worship choir can't sit behind me to raise anthems in adoration of the Lord, whom we all love and adore. It's sad that Muddy Boots can't raise contemporary songs of praise to glorify the Lord. It's sad that the Puddle Jumpers are missing the opportunity to sing and play instruments that teach them how to love, worship, and serve the Lord. What's the phrase that I want to bring into your vocabulary? It's actually two phrases that I've coined as one. PTL, or praise the Lord. And PTL, praise the Lord from this Sunday on. Some adults will remember a song written by Cole Porter. Frank and Ryan, are either of you familiar with Cole Porter? Frank? Oh my God, I'm that old. So Cole Porter is known for songs like I've Got You Under My Skin. Oh yeah. And I've Got My Eyes on You. And You Do Something to Me. And finally, he wrote From This Moment On, which was included in MGM's 1953 film, Kiss Me, Kate. You may remember the lyrics. From this moment on, you for me, dear, only two for tea, dear. From this moment on, from this happy day, no more blues songs, only hoop-dee-doo songs. From this moment on. His song was a testimony of love and devotion to his beloved. He only wanted to have a relationship with her. He anticipated happy days. There would be no more dark blue songs. There would only be happy hoop-dee-doo songs from this moment on. Of course, we've all heard men and women making promises of love and devotion to another lover. Please don't tell Debbie that there were other women before her, because I told these other women before her that it would only be her. Debbie, if you're watching, turn off your Zoom. we've all done it, because the only way that we got to the place where we are with the wives that we have is that we had relationships with other women, other men, and we got to the place where we said, you are the one. And finally, for me, I found Debbie. And now here we are, 44 years into our marriage, after a 2-year relationship, 44 years we are married. And it's permanent. And we know that it is now until death do us part. And so we continue. But sadly, there are so many people who have made these same commitments and something went awry. One or both of them became unfaithful. One or both of them became started becoming harmful. They did other issues that failed them in their marriage, and the marriage has failed. On my side of the family alone, I sat the other day and started thinking, including my siblings, uncles, aunts, and cousins, nieces, and nephews, there are 9 divorces. And all of them probably started with a song similar to From This Moment On. Well, that's the reason that I want to add a couple of new phrases to your vocabulary. PTL, praise the Lord, from this Sunday on. But I'm not the only one who wants to insert the primary phrase, PTL, into your vocabulary, your heart, mind, and soul. The other person who wants to elevate your daily glossary is an unknown psalmist. And all he wants to teach us is that we should all praise the Lord today and every day of our lives. So PTL, from this Sunday on, is what I want to get into your hearing and mind, praise language. I only wanted the first 4 verses read initially so that I could get your attention with the PTL. But I really want you to get a sense of the whole psalm. I wish we could all read and understand Hebrew, because if we could, we would see something very unique in this psalm. We would notice that this psalm, like several other psalms, are written in the form of an acrostic. Using the Hebrew alphabet, so that with the exception of the opening line, praise the Lord, in Hebrew, praise is hallelujah. So after hallelujah, there are actually 22 lines of poetry or music, each line beginning with a successive letter of the Hebrew alphabet. There are only 22 letters for the Hebrew alphabet, and they are Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, He, Vav, Zion, Chet, Tet, Yod, Kaf, Lamed, Mem, Nun, Samek, Ayin, Pe, Fe, Sade, Kof, Resh, Shin, and Tav. But of course, because our English translations can't follow the Hebrew alphabet literally, we miss out on the acrostic. But the psalmist's message is obvious in each verse of the psalm. Listen to the psalm. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart in the company of the upright, in the congregation. Great are the works of the Lord, studied by all who delight in the Lord. Full of honor and majesty is his work, and righteousness endures forever. He has gained renown by his wonderful deeds. The Lord is gracious and merciful. He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers his covenant. He has shown his people the power of his works, giving them the lands of the other nations. The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever, enacted in faithfulness and uprightness. He provided redemption for his people. He ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal hallelujah. This song was expected to be sung as a congregational song. You can sing it by yourself, but it really was intended as a congregational song so that we could each remind each other of the reasons why we should praise the Lord in spirit and in word. And we should be willing and able to openly confess our faith and devotion to the Lord and to do it out loud. So the psalmist says, hallelujah, praise the Lord, with a clear and obvious exclamation point mark at the end of the hallelujah. An exclamatory sentence is one that expresses a strong and forceful emotion. And in this verse, it says, pay attention. This is important. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Then he presents his acrostic using the 22 phrases, each beginning with the Hebrew alphabet. It's almost as though he has a Twitter account and wants to tell all his followers and anyone who just happens to check in their feed and sees, look, somebody's just sent out a Twitter notice, and look at what they've sent out. They're sending out a praise notice. It's got 280 characters, but instead of 280 characters, this tweeter opted instead to use 22 phrases, and it runs way over the 280 characters. In essence, he's saying, praise the Lord, and he gives thanks with his whole heart. Praise the Lord in the congregation. Praise the Lord for his great deeds. Praise the Lord for all his wondrous works and amazing things that he's done. Praise the Lord because he's full of honor and majesty. Praise the Lord because his righteousness endures forever. Praise the Lord for all his wonderful deeds. Praise the Lord because he's gracious and merciful. Praise the Lord because he feeds all who fear him. Praise the Lord because he keeps his covenant. Praise the Lord because he's shown his power in all creation. Praise the Lord, for he has given Abraham's children the lands of other nations. Praise the Lord, because he is faithfulness and just. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. He just keeps on going. Now, if you had to write your own tweet to tell someone why you praise the Lord, what would you say? Let me tell you what I would say. My tweet would go something like this. PTL for God's holiness. PTL for his eternal presence. PTL for the beauty of creation. PTL for the sun, the moon, and the stars, and all the planets and universes. PTL for all animals of land, sea, air, and even microscopic animals. PTL for giving me his righteousness. PTL for his goodness and mercy. PTL for Debbie, my wife, my children, Leah, Corinne, and Chris, for my grandchildren, Dance, Jaden, Johnny, Jordan, Gabriel, and Michael. PTL for for sending his only son, my Savior and Lord. PTL, that Jesus died on that old rugged cross. PTL, that Jesus' death forgave me of all my sins. PTL, that he stayed in that tomb until the third day. PTL, that he got up on that third day, proving that death couldn't keep him in the ground. PTL, because his death and resurrection paid the price of my salvation. PTL, his resurrection assures me that by faith in Jesus, I know I have eternal life. That's just 15 lines of text. I could go on indefinitely, but I think you get my drift. Every day we awaken, we've got new reasons to praise the Lord. We can just say, praise the Lord, and say what you're praising him for, and the Lord will be honored. When you speak to a friend or family member, say, PTL, for the Lord today. And I said, PTL, what's that? Oh, it says, praise the Lord. And why are you praising the Lord? Look at me. I am alive and well. PTL. PTL. From this Sunday on, I hope that you will loosen your mind, heart, soul, tongue, teeth, and lips and voice to praise the Lord. Amen. Father, I bless you and praise you for the opportunity to praise you. I pray that you will, in fact, loosen the minds, hearts, souls, tongues, and voices of each and every listener to be able to confess a public praise by just saying PTL. And when asked what is PTL, that they can then testify, praise the Lord for giving me a new day to live and move and have my being. Thank you, Lord. Amen. May the light always shine in your darkness. May your ears always hear the word. May grace upon grace be yours, and may the glory of the Father's only Son be known to you now and forever. Amen.